Hello everyone. I honestly never thought I'd ever make this video. I didn't think anyone would want to hear me talk about this topic ever, since it's always being debated. And I think this will probably be my only video that I dedicate to this topic, so I'm going to try to touch on as many things as I can. I wasn't originally planning to do this video ever, but I sort of felt inclined to after my last video titled K-pop Hard to Swallow Pills. I said that no one cared about cultural appropriation and that the reason it had no real-world consequence was because of the fake woke stans online who didn't actually care about it. And some people agreed, some didn't, and I got a lot of messages and tweets sent to me about what I said, but I felt like a 30-second segment in one video wasn't enough for me to explain myself. First, I want to say what cultural appropriation is and why people have a problem with it. Cultural appropriation is the inappropriate adoption of customs, practices, ideas, etc. of a people/society by members of another and typically more dominant people/society. Today, cultural appropriation in entertainment and media is commonly using or stealing a culture for aesthetic purposes without really respecting it or the people whose culture it comes from. People were accusing me of saying cultural appropriation isn't a problem and that it doesn't affect people in the real world, which I disagree with. I never even talked about how cultural appropriation affects the people whose cultures are being used, so I don't get how people thought I was glossing over that. Of course, there is double standards sometimes where minorities or anyone else does something that belongs to their own culture, it could be looked down upon. But when someone not a part of that culture partakes in it, they're praised. The best example someone gave me is when black women wear box braids or other black hairstyles and they could be discriminated against or called ghetto and given a negative image. But when non-black people wear them, they're cool and trendy and fashionable. I agree it's messed up and that it skews people's perceptions of minorities in different ways, especially in Korea and K-pop. But I think that's a result of just systemic racism and not specifically cultural appropriation. People don't think box braids on black girls are ghetto because they genuinely believe non-black girls look better in them. They think it's ghetto because our society is racist to black people and many other races and minority groups. Then because of that racism, cultural appropriation is then validated since the culture being appropriated doesn't come from the people being oppressed. What I'm trying to say is, I don't think cultural appropriation is the root cause of discrimination. It can definitely affect it, especially in entertainment and media, but it's not the source. Racism and discrimination aren't a consequence of cultural appropriation, it's the other way around. That's partly why I said cultural appropriation has no consequence. Another reason why I said cultural appropriation has no real-world consequence is because you see so many celebrities literally build their entire career off cultural appropriation, and it literally doesn't affect them whatsoever. Artists like Justin Bieber, Miley Cyrus, Katy Perry, and so many others have built a large part of their careers off cultural appropriation, and it absolutely did not affect them at all in the long run. They all still have their careers, despite all the people canceling them over and over, and it didn't do anything to them in real life. When someone cancels a celebrity for cultural appropriation, it has no real-world consequence at all. No one actually calls it out or makes real-world action about it in real life, and even in the rare time it does, there's still no consequence. No one actually calls it out or makes real-world action about it in real life. Someone made the point of the fashion brand Gucci always using other cultures in their collections, and even if people make a big deal of it online, Gucci isn't losing customers and no one is boycotting them and no one who actually calls it out online does anything to stop it in real life. That's why it was such a hard pill to swallow. Cultural appropriation has no real-world consequence, whether or not you believe it's bad or a real issue. Now, taking this back to K-pop specifically, personally, I don't think cultural appropriation is okay, and I really dislike the way that it's used in K-pop. It's very blatant across the entire industry and the way it steals and cherry picks part of black culture and music specifically, and copying a lot of the time instead of being influenced. Sometimes I disagree with what people deem as cultural appropriation, especially now since people like to immediately cancel nowadays, but it is still a big problem, I think, even if it isn't maliciously intentional. Is that to say K-pop can't use hip-hop or rap at all in its music? No, not at all. K-pop has always been a mix of popular music in the West, along with its own twist to make it unique and appealing to Korean audiences. I think Black fans just want the artists and idols not to disrespect the culture and the people who it's coming from. And Korean artists may use hip-hop and rap a lot in K-pop music, but there's still a very negative image of Black people in Korea and other Asian countries, so I think that's where people have a problem with it. Moving on, in my video I also said people don't actually care about cultural appropriation in the real world, they just pretend to for woke points to cancel celebrities and idols. It was a bit of an exaggeration, but I still stand by what I said. Of course, if someone's culture is being appropriated, they have the right on whether or not to be offended and upset, and their feelings on it are valid. It was exaggerated for me to say that absolutely nobody cares about it, but I would say the majority of people don't actually care about cultural appropriation on social media, but just pretend to for clout and to be edgy. I firmly believe this, and you can tell that whenever an idol does something questionable or problematic, all stans take it among themselves to cancel them and focus on the canceling more than the problematic behavior at hand. You can also tell it's fake by the deflection of stans bringing up other idols' problematic behavior too, when it has absolutely nothing to do with anything. People online treat canceling like it's a competition on who's done the most problematic things. No one actually cares about the issues. It's also very selective when people cancel, since there's always certain idols people love to slander the most. So here's just a PSA. All idols have done something problematic, whether it was cultural appropriation or something else. You look stupid trying to put your faves on a pedestal for being less problematic because it shows you don't actually care about the issues, but rather your fave's image. So just stop. Like I said before, it's not a contest on who's more problematic, but there's definitely people who turn a blind eye to certain idols while crucifying others. A lot of people who like to brag about how woke and unproblematic their faves are really gloss over a lot of things that they've done, since either they didn't blow up or they just don't think it's as big of an issue. And that's all I'm going to say on that. Also, people need to understand that not everyone has the same deep understanding of cultures and cultural appropriation. A lot of people had never even heard of the term cultural appropriation until social media. You expect all these idols to understand the reasons on why it's not okay when there are people who are exposed to many people and many cultures who never even saw the problem with it in the first place. Also, especially since there are people who aren't offended by cultural appropriation when it happens to their own culture, how are people supposed to automatically know it's wrong when so many people have different viewpoints on it? That's not to say if an idol cultural appropriates over and over again, despite knowing that it's bad and they're being called out for it, that they shouldn't be held accountable, but people expect them to have this deep understanding of other cultures from the get-go. And like I said before, Korea isn't exactly the most welcoming place in the world to other cultures, and the country is very homogeneous in itself, so that's just to put some perspective on things. Now speaking for myself, if one of my faves does culturally appropriate, I want them to acknowledge it, apologize, and learn. What I won't do is cancel them and stop standing because I don't see how that helps anybody. If I did that, they would just continue what they're doing without even knowing that it was wrong. Also, if I cancel them, that doesn't give them the opportunity to apologize or learn. And if you can brag about your fave apologizing and learning from their mistakes, that means you gave them the opportunity and the time to grow and apologize. So clearly you didn't cancel them when they screwed up in the first place. And I should be able to do the same for my faves. Alright, so basically those are all my views on cultural appropriation and everything that I said. Hopefully this clears up a lot of what I said in my last video and what I meant. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video.